Welcome to Wallington Filming.
Yeah, so until next time, from the Candleman. Catch
you. Hi, you guys, welcome back to Wallington Filming, painting and decorating trade secrets. Right, today we're doing a little video on adding black to your top coat paint. Is it a myth or is it reality? Well, I'm afraid to say yes. There's still companies or guys out there that dip a stick in the black gloss and add it to their finish coat, whether it's gloss or satin finish or eggshell. Yes, they dip the stick in the black gloss just a little bit and add it to the finish coat of paint. Now, wonders will never cease to why there's still guys out there that do this and companies that still do this. And I personally have known about this for over 20 years, and in actual fact I did actually used to do it myself. Not for very long though, because what happened was I put too much black in the gallery tin, and all my woodwork looked like battleship grey, yeah. And it cost me 2 days money for two of the blokes to re-gloss the plot, because you walked in and it just looked grey. So after that I didn't do it again, because it's like a very, very fine art to just getting that correct amount in without going over the top. So yeah, there is guys and there is companies out there that are still doing it, and I've worked for two companies in the last 12 months and one of them still does it to this day. You can't believe it, can you? Hey. But, right, so what I've basically got here is two tins of oil-based satin finish, and this one's got black in it, and this one hasn't. This actually comes mixed with black directly from the place that the paint's bought from. So, can't mention names for legal reasons, but one of the companies that I've worked for in the 12-month period, you actually go down, get your paint, and a bit of black's added before you take it out of the shop. I can't tell you that it's for legal reasons, obviously, but anybody that knows me knows who it is, but I'm not mentioning names because I'm not allowed. And this one would be from the other company, exactly the same paint, both Dulux trade, yeah, satin finish, tough durable finish, both exactly the same. But one of them, as far as I'm concerned, looks like battleship grey. I'm not joking, it's crap. And I'm going to give you a bit of an example by. I've got skirtboards painted in this already, and this is the one without any black in it, and I'm just going to show you, I'll be putting a bit of this pure brilliant white with no black in it over the top of the skirting boards that this is painted in, just so you can see the difference. And trust me, there is a big, big difference. I personally think in this day and age it's not necessary to add any black in it. To be honest, I don't even know why I used to do it myself. I didn't even know the reason for doing it. I just did it because everybody else was doing it. But nowadays, I don't think it's necessary. And people that do add black, unless they can tell me otherwise, I think it's a bit of a mistake. Because especially if you're doing working for a big builder, and you're adding black to the white gloss or the white satin or whatever, I should imagine if they got to find out, they won't be too happy about it. Because if you look at it, especially here, if you can see pure white walls, there it is, skateboards, painted in satin, with the black that's been added, and personally I think it looks like battleship grey, you know, the grey colour that you paint the battleships with. There it is. So, but I should imagine, you know, if you're working for big builders and they actually found out that you were adding black, I don't think you'd be too happy about it. Now, a lot of people, why they add black, they're saying it helps it cover on top of the undercoat. I don't know what it's supposed to do. You're supposed to add a bit of black to it. Let's say your gloss, for instance, add a bit, little bit of black to it, get it good stir up. But when you've undercoated your frames or doors or whatever, because you've added that black, it helps the paint cover over the top of the undercoat. I personally think it's a load of bollocks. Yeah, I don't think it's. In actual fact, I think it's worse. I've just done this great big 5-bedroom house with no heating and no lights on, I might add. And on the frames, you've got to double satin finish it, because when that first coat of satin's fully dry, and I did like lather the satin on with a 3-inch brush on the frames, with loads on it, but when it dries, you have a close look at it and it's streaking. It's like you can see the undercoat showing through. But I'll show you a bit of a close up of that as well. I think basically it's not a myth. It still happens. People still put black in it. And if I was to give anybody advice, I'd say don't do it, because it's, I think it's just too risky. And I did hear that people used to do it because there was more oil in the paint years ago, but I did. And then I was also told that, you know, there's not so much oil in it now, so there's no need to be putting black in it. And I did hear a rumour from one of the lads that a certain individual, who can't mention names for legal reasons, actually used to put magnolia mulch in his white to help it cover. I don't know how true that is, but fuck's sake, can you imagine? Hey, magnolia in your white mulching. I've never heard of that before. But yeah, okay, so there it is. People still do it. And I personally wouldn't recommend doing it. I actually have had to paint this plot here with oil-based satin, which has had black already mixed to it. And I think that, personally, I think it's just not any better. I think it's worse, if anything. Because like I was saying, on the frames, after the first coat's dried, I looked at it and like, it's streaky. It's like you can see the undercoat running through. So you've got to get two coats anyway. So yeah, guys, don't do it. It's like, for the old school painters, you know, when paint was different and times were different. Nowadays you shouldn't be doing it. Plus, if you ever have to touch up your woodwork, you've got to get it, like, if you've mixed it yourself, you've got to get it spot on, ain't you? So I wouldn't advise it. So without further ado, boys and girls, let me show you me painting a little bit of skateboard, only a little bit, not going to do a lot, so I'll wipe it off, in the satin finish that's had no black. And just look at the difference. Okay, let me show you.
Right then, guys, let me show you an example on these frames when you've had black added to your Dulux Trait satin finish. Let me just show you what these frames look like.
Right, guys, hopefully you can see these frames here. Right, these have all been undercoated and had one coat of satin finish, right? So I don't know when you can tell it, but they either look fucking grey or like a lilac colour. I'm not sure whether you can tell the difference on this, really. But there they are. See if you can see the difference. You see, you've got white ceilings and walls. And what happens is, because it's had, me and the guys think, because it's had black added to the tin before we get it, right, we think that's why we have to give it two coats of satin. Because basically what happens is when it's dried out, now I'm going to try and show you this. Might be a little bit difficult. Well, you can see it. But you can actually see the white undercoat grinning through the satin fit. Ah, you should be able to see it. Can you see that? Can you see that looks a little bit streaky? That's because when it's dry and it's had black added to it, it goes a bit streaky and you can see the white undercoat coming through the top coat. Look, you must be able to see that. I hope you can see that. Fucking unbelievable. That's why I've now got to give these frames another coat of satin to get rid of that. Right guys, here's the satin finish and it's got no black added to it. So what I'm going to do is just coat a bit of this up, just so you can see the difference. Yeah? Right. There you go. I don't know if you can see it very well on film, but there's a section, pure white, and there it is. Where this one here is obviously got the black in it. And there is a big difference. And I just don't think there's any need. I mean, that's covered lovely. That pure brilliant white. Look at the difference, look. It's like a grey blue colour. You know what I mean? So, don't do it because I don't think it's necessary. And if you see it from a distance, you know, the one with the black in it, it literally looks great. I don't know how people dare do it. I think it's just too risky. If a contracts manager picked you up on it, he'd have to be recoating it all up, wouldn't he? So, oh. Right guys, just a bit of a close up there, look. That one there is pure brilliant white. The one on next to the tin has got black in it. I mean, there's a massive difference, isn't there? And it's just not necessary. So don't do it. Why add black ink to your gloss or eggshell or satin finish? Crazy. Look at the difference. Right then guys, so there you have it. Adding black to your top coat of paint. Myth or reality? Well, it's a reality, I can assure you, because I've just painted this whole plot in a paint that's got black added to it. And as you said, massive difference, isn't it? It's not necessary. I've painted plots with pure brilliant white, gloss and satin, and it's got no black added to it, and it's perfectly all right. So I don't know why some people still add it, because I think it's worse, to be honest. And I think the repercussions of doing it could be catastrophic, to say the least. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this little video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks to all my subscribers who've done so already. And don't forget to keep checking the list of videos. We've got new videos coming out every week and some brilliant stuff there. So, from yours truly, the Candleman. Until next time, catch you later. We'll be right back.
for watching Warrington Filming.
Yeah.
It's me here, Johnny fucking Vegas. How are you, kid? Glad to meet you. If you want to see me, I'm in fucking Benidorm tonight. Honky conky.
From the Candleman. Sorry. I don't want to say sorry about language, but hey. Until next time, catch you later.